How come you're using the tubes?
You want to use the tubes.
You've joined a journey traveling the country and experiencing creativity and art demonstrations. And now we're live in a city near you, whoever you might be. It's the Kraaft It Live Art Concert, an art show with fun, laughter, and a few mistakes thrown in too. Follow along on Instagram and see behind the scenes images by D-Dog, fielding your YouTube questions, Sylvia and Mr. Crafter. And now your host, Heather Crafter.
And hello and welcome to Kraaft It Live. It is Heather here. Did we even do the color? Did we set the colors? Probably not, huh? So we're doing really well today. It's been a crazy week here, and it's only Tuesday. So Welcome to Kraaft It Live. That's how this works. So we have some fun stuff today. Watercolors, that's what we'll be working on. And I wanted to just play today. And you know how, like, when you have, I have Fabriano paper, this in multiple sizes. This is all one sheet that we've just sort of tore down into a few different sizes. But you know how when you, like, play an instrument. Anybody in the audience plays an instrument or ever did play an instrument or attempted to try and learn to play an instrument? What was the one thing that you had to do? Sylvia raised her hand. So what was the one thing you had to do?
Practice.
Practice. And it wasn't just practice. Like, you know, you're born to know how to play this song and then you just start playing it, right? No.
Right.
It was those ridiculous
scales. I hated the scales.
Everybody hates the scales.
I hated the
scales. And you know what? It's kind of the same with your art. You kind of have to do the scales.
Got to do the scales.
But I have an idea today. We're going to do the scales, quote unquote. This is my air quotes. The scales, and it's going to be enjoyable.
Oh, yeah. Right. Okay, fine.
Sure.
Sure.
All right. Well, before we get into all of that, Sylvia is here, and she is got her finger poised to talk to the audience. It's so funny. She has her laptop in front of her. I should take a picture and post on Instagram, don't you think?
No.
Oh,
okay.
Come on. Anyway,
no,
she has her finger
me.
Poised on her laptop, ready to scroll through the list of everybody, and I'll shut up and let her talk.
Okay, I want to say hi to Jazzy and Linz. Linz is here. Yay, she hasn't been able to join us for a while.
Not to say that we aren't happy that Jazzy's here.
No, I know.
Because, I mean, I know that you didn't mean it that way.
No, I didn't mean it that way. But Linz has been so busy with her new Hammy, where we're getting Hammy diary.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Oh, my gosh. And Hammy's adventures and the places he's going and the write-up that Hammy's doing, he is fantastic.
Yep,
Hammy
very
does
cool.
a wonderful job.
Very
so
cool.
If you guys don't subscribe to her newsletter or you don't follow Linz, you got to follow Linz because you got to see
on
those
it.
Adventures. They're just
Get
wonderful.
On it. You're missing out.
And then Mary Sewell is here, and Liz is here, and Enclave Soldier, who's Junk, is here, and Angel is here, and we have, I know we got a couple more. Hang on. Oh, Kathleen Hartley is here, and Freedom Deep is here. Okay, cool.
All right, well, we're glad you're all here, and we are getting ready, as usual. T-Dog is snapping behind the scenes close-up shots and whatnot, and those will be posted over on Instagram. If you don't follow us on Instagram, that's one of the things you miss out on over there. Every Tuesday, he takes pictures that make it look even better. It's just like you're being in it's like you're here in real life when he does
that's
that.
Right. I just noticed when you were working with the Crinacridone Gold that it's almost the color of your nail polish.
Oh, I got the nails done yesterday. Can you see the nails? And, oh, those, look at those nails. Look at that. How did we do that? We didn't even talk on the phone or anything, and we match.
That's pretty. I like that. That's a pretty
I knew
color.
You would. I thought of that.
Oh,
when
I like that a lot. I'm going to have to find
it's,
out what that
it's
color
cat
is.
Eye.
Oh,
it's cat
I can
eye.
See that.
Yeah. And
oh,
so it's
I,
like
I
that.
I got to get me some of that.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
All right.
Okay, can I?
We'll move on to art now.
No, I need my devotional.
Oh, you want the devotional. All right, go
okay.
ahead.
Today's message is, whether you turn to the right or the left, your ears will hear a voice behind you saying, this is the way, walk in it. Isaiah 30, verse 21. That is a great saying.
Yeah, that's, hey, God's good like that, eh?
Yeah, I like that. That is
okay,
great.
So here's what we've got. All right, I got to make sure I keep these in the order they are that I put them on the pan. Okay, so I'm working with straight out of the tube this today, okay? And we are going to,
and you don't have to,
because I only wanted to work with these colors. I don't want to be tempted by the whole palette.
Okay.
Some people only use tube paints anyway.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give it a shot and see why, but whatever. I have two of basically almost the same colors. They're almost the same colors, but they're by different companies. So that's why I thought we'll see what they're like. This one here in this corner is M. Graham Nickel Crinacridone Gold. This one over here is Daniel Smith Crinacridone Gold. So no nickel in that one. And I've got blue all over my hands. As you can see, I've done that. This one is from Mission Gold series, the Gold series of Mission.
Uh-huh.
paints. There's another word that I can never say. It's trillulululo or whatever. I don't know. Anyway, blue peacock is that color there.
What color is that?
Blue peacock.
Oh, okay.
And then this one is M. Graham turquoise.
So not the phthalo blue.
No. And I said in our Facebook group that we're going to use phthalo blue green shade.
Yeah.
Because that's my absolute favorite color. I was wrong. It's turquoise.
Oh.
I didn't realize that. I had it marked wrong.
Okay, cool.
Shocking. Me. I made a mistake. I got to wash my hands real quick.
Okay, while she's washing her hands, I want to say hi to Laura, who joined us. And Lisa, my electric life. I love that. She joined us, too. So, hi, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. It's going to be fun, like always.
Lisa has a very eclectic life. She's so cool the way she has been doing the live videos and recorded videos. Have you seen any of those? They're really cool. And she does everything. She does weaving. Spinning. Not weaving. Spinning.
Spinning.
Yeah.
Wow.
Not just mixed media. Not just junk journals. She does it everything. It's cool. Anyway, all right. So I've got, like I said at the beginning, this is Fabriano cold press paper. It's 140 pound. I've just taken one sheet.
That's
it's
only 140 pound.
Yeah, it's Artistico.
Wow.
And
awesome.
We took one large sheet, the 22x30 or whatever it is, and we broke it down into multiple sheets. So this is a very economical way to play, because this sheet itself I think might have cost me $3, and we got all these to play with.
It's the best way to do it. Plus, then you get the decal edges, too.
Well, and that's always fun, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's try not to move that. My bad. Okay, so.
Lynn's saying that she's too much of a klutz to use tubes because she gets it all over the place, so she just loves her half pain.
Well, obviously, so do I, because I got it all over my hands and then had to wash my hands already, and we haven't even started. So you're not alone, girlfriend. So, this is what we're going to do. We're going to start with making sure I got the right size. So there's two sides to every piece of paper. That was genius what I just said right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, but we know what you mean.
But there's the right side and the wrong side. At least with artistical paper, there's a wrong side. So how can you tell? This one's slightly more textured than this side.
Yeah.
And I didn't think it used to matter until I accidentally started on the wrong side and was like, what in the world? It's not acting right. And I don't know if it's they only size one side of it. I don't know. Mm. But doesn't really matter. We just look real quick and now we're good. I got a great big brush. And I get teased all the time about my great big brush. You don't have to use a big brush, but I like using a big brush whenever I'm putting down a lot of color. Now you saw how very little I touched over here. I'm in the palette over here on the right of the screen. And you saw how very little I touched. I just have nothing but water on there, and then I just touch and make that color come out. So there's a lot of paint on here. And what's really awesome about this, what is this thing even called? A porcelain plate, is that I can leave the paint on there and just use it again.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's just a pan, basically, without the border, right?
Right.
So we're just going to make ourselves a wash. Just add some water here and make ourselves a wash. And look at how beautiful that gold color is. Isn't that pretty?
I love the quinacridone gold color.
And this one is nickel quinacridone gold.
Azo gold.
No azo.
No azo,
not
just
in this
nickel
one.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, so we got a pretty good wash there. We're going to just go ahead and...
And that's dry paper, right?
And dry paper.
Okay.
We're just going to go right across. So remember I said at the very beginning, none of us really like to do scales. I mean, we'll just be honest with it. Whenever we're doing music, or in this case, be like practicing how to do a wash, that's what we're doing here. But if we do this, so I have a pretty good even wash. Notice I'm not going over it 100 times, just big long strokes, and anywhere that it's not even, there we go. It's all good. Nice even color, looks like a pretty good wash. It's very light, and we want that on purpose because we're going to have fun. Remember I said we're going to have fun? So we'll set that aside.
That's the yellow scale.
There you go. And that's pretty much what we're going to be doing all day today.
Okay, Lisa wants you to explain what is the right side again.
Okay, so when I'm looking at the Artistico paper, now this is specific to Fabriano. I don't know that they're all like this,
right.
But definitely Fabriano Artistico paper on one side, and you're probably not going to be able to see on screen, mm-hmm. but on one side is definitely more textured than the other side.
Yeah.
The other side, it appears smoother.
Mm-hmm.
There's no way you're going to get a picture of that, T-Dog, sorry. Yep. So we're going to do this three times, same as before. Same as before. Because we just got to get that. Now, right away, I already did something wrong.
Uh-oh.
You see my box I made? You're not supposed to outline a box. You're not supposed to do that. When you want to make a flat wash, you need to keep it wet. There we go. All right. Phew, save the day. All right. So what you need to do, we're going to do this one more time, and I will talk about it hopefully as I'm doing it. Again, find the more textured side. And it's not totally obvious. You'll know when you start painting on it if it's the right side or not. But okay, so I have my brush loaded up with the wash. And now you want to just start where you want to start and then sort of overlap a little bit, but you're not trying to, it's not like, I guess this is kind of like painting a wall, if you've ever painted a wall, and you can kind of tell as you're drying, as the paintbrush is drying out, you need to come back and get, and you got to do this quickly so it doesn't dry, because you don't want that overlap to then create a second layer. So now you have a nice wash, but don't keep going over it, because if you do, you end up with, like, that right there is not flat. Yeah, I don't know if they can see that or not, but you can see that there's sort of a darker line in here because I went over it twice.
I can see it.
Okay.
I'll vouch for it.
Okay. All right, so that would be
I just want to clarify something, okay?
Yeah.
Because Lisa is still asking, you know, the more textured side is the right side. And I have to say that depends, because I know some people don't like that side and will go with the smoother side. So, like in this case with Heather, she knows that the more textured side on this Fabriano paper is what she would consider the right side, because she's actually worked on both sides and everything works better on the nubbier side, the rougher side, the more textured side.
Right.
But and there's other cases, though. There's other water paper where some people like the smoother side.
That's true. That's true. It just doesn't react the way that you would
right.
expect water paper to react
right.
on the other side. So in truth, it should be not right side, wrong side, but rather this is the side I prefer.
Yeah, there you go.
All right. So now we have four of these. Yeah, I think that's a society issue in wording right there, because saying right side, wrong side doesn't mean good side, bad side.
Right.
It's the right side for me is this side that I am showing you here. So, yep. Okay, so these are going to dry. These are going to dry, and as they do that, let's move this over. And let's do one, we're going to do this larger one with the blue. And I need to rinse my brush out real good. Okay, so we're gonna use this blue peacock from Mission Gold.
Oh, good.
And we'll just make a nice little well right here of color. This one, it looks like it requires a lot more pigment added to the water to get a good color. All right, and we're going to just basically do the same thing, but we're going to do it into wet. So take a brush, and I don't want to get rid of that pigment, so I'm going to take a different brush. And I'm just going to use clean water. And that's not the brush I want. Here it is. I got a great big mop brush here, flat. Okay, so we're going to take clean water, and we're basically going to do exactly what we had already done, but with water. And I'm trying not to go over it too much. So even if you see me go over it, I'm really not touching it very much. I'm just trying to even it out.
And the brush is getting drier too, so it's not laying down as much wet.
So here we go. All right. Now, I'm looking off to the side so that I can see a sheen. I will show you as soon as T takes a picture, but you got to move quick, bud. All right. All right, so there's a sheen to the paper that I can see. With that sheen, I know now that I can go ahead and drop this in and watch it spread. Now, this will give us a lighter, it's like we're adding water to it, but we added water to the paper first. So it'll give us a lighter version of a wash. And I'm just pulling it out now from this left-hand side, pulling that color out, because there's quite a bit more color up here. So we'll just pull it down. You see that? And I love these blooms on the corners. Yeah. I think we're going to add some more. So now I've just got clean water on my brush, Now I just clean my brush with clean water, dab it off just a little bit. And I'm just going to add some water into these areas here.
Oh my gosh, she's amazing. Lynn's just posted a thing already. Oh my gosh, the paper's got two sides. She's incredible.
She's incredible that she picks up on all the goofy things I say.
But she drew it.
All right, now, this wasn't where I was going with it, but I want to. Sometimes you got to let it take you, right?
Right.
It's like a little jam session going on.
Yeah.
It's just happening. I can't stop it. Sorry. Nope, just jam, no peanut butter. All right, so I put a lot of water on this corner so that it would bloom, which was really cool. But then when I moved it, I was like, ooh, look at what it's doing. So then I put some over here, and this sort of the same thing happened. And I don't want these puddles to happen, so I'm just sort of moving it, and I like where it's moving to. So this is just sort of a side note. This isn't where we were going today, but now this over here is
kind of scale we're working on, people.
Yeah, this is where you start moving your fingers a little bit faster, and the teacher's like, excuse me, did I say that you could do that yet? And this teacher, the one that's teaching you today, says, go ahead. All right.
Lynn's is saying that she's a hot press smooth girl most of the time, as it's better for illustrating. But if I try and paint something like a tree or park, I like the cold press, the rough stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm not much of an illustrator, so to me, the hot press is just a waste of money to me. I have tried, but... All right, we're going to add some more water here. I like where this is going. This is like that two-tone stuff. Let's put some more water in. I don't know if you guys can see that or not, but it's going to create some blooms, and who knows, that might be a tree. Sylvia, there's a... Do you see it over there?
Oh, blanket?
Yeah.
No, I want my cape.
Oh, my goodness. Arizona, it's like 100 million degrees outside, and she's covering up with my apron.
I'm covering up with it. Don't you dare
take a picture of me. Can you see it? You guys, can you see the landscape there?
Yeah, sure you're not. Yeah. I'm going to fly.
That's looking pretty cool. All right, I have the two of them. Oh my goodness! All right, I have a brush here. This I cleaned it and I've dried it off. It is dry brush basically, and we're just going to go in here and sort of wipe out some of this color. before it's dry.
Ooh, way to capture that sheen, T-Dog. Excellent job.
So again, these are the Mission Gold. This is Mission Gold paint.
This is?
Yeah, this one is. All right, so that's already starting to dry down there. So we're just going to let that be what it's going to be. Can you see it already?
Isn't that pretty? Yeah.
I haven't even done anything other than lay down water and paint. That looks pretty neat.
Yeah, it does.
You don't see a landscape yet?
Oh, yeah.
Big time. All right, well, we'll see if I can stretch T-Dog's imagination before the day is done. All right, I'm going to set it over here to dry, and these should be dry now. All right, so scale number one is complete. We did a wash. Now, this wash is not perfect, but...
Kathleen says she sees a lake at the bottom.
Yeah, I did too.
And Lisa says I see one too.
All right, so now what we're going to do is grab a much smaller brush. This should make you happy, Linz. I've got a much smaller brush. It's a number 8. You can
really
see it
tiny.
In compared to my thumb.
Wow.
Teensy weensy for me,
yeah,
right?
That's real tiny for you.
All right, and now I've got to somehow get comfortable because this is hard.
Oh, God, it's funny. You should see what I'm seeing, people.
This is so hard for me to paint on this table right now. We're trying to get razors or risers or whatever so that it will be higher for me, but whatever. It's my own personal battle here. So.
Well, why don't you just put a chair behind you?
I don't have a high chair. Yeah, I need a high chair because I'm like 2. All right, here we go. Are you ready?
Lynn's just fainted. That's what she said. Because you got a smaller brush, she just fainted.
All right.
What color? What color?
It's the same exact color.
Okay.
Same exact color that we used on it already. I may mix just a little bit more.
A little stronger.
A little bit stronger. Add just this pigment. You don't need lots. Can you tell?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just barely touching that pigment there. All right, that should be good. A little T-Dog's poised with the camera.
Isn't it right
this
there?
Is the M-gram,
yeah.
Yep. I'm trying. I'm sorry. Okay, gosh, I'm getting yelled at by everybody around me. Okay, here we go.
Anumati's here, and she says she saw a landscape on the blue one also.
Good. I will tell you, this is hard to do without it taped down. Tell you that right now. But this is just practice. All right. I know you're going to freak out. You're like, what in the world is she doing? It's okay. Just hang with me. Hang with me. I'm turning the paper so that way I can get a better version, I guess, of it for myself. I may have to switch brushes because this one is actually, don't freak out, Linz, but it's actually too big.
Too big?
Yep.
I-17 crosses I-10.
I know, it does kind of look that way right now.
Well, I see a tree and then the background of the hill.
Oops.
Well, I did. I just made an X. X marks the spot.
Wow. Now, was this in your mind, or are you just making this up as you go?
It was in my mind.
It was in your mind?
I'm letting it out.
Okay.
So, the reason why I chose to do these lines is because I wanted this to be simple for somebody watching if they wanted to practice or play along. And if they're just doing these abstract lines with me, they're basically... somewhat parallel lines. They can be curved if you want to, a little more organic. It's almost like we're close up into the weeds or something,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I like that. I like the depth that that's
All right,
showing.
As we keep going, you want the thinnest brush you can possibly get your hands on because I don't like how fat these
Yeah, Lynn's
lines
is saying
are.
That you're doing her in because the brush is too big.
It really is. Just keep going behind. Let's do a curved one right here. Sorry, it keeps moving on me. It's much better if you can tape this down, but to do so many for the live show, honestly, if I was doing this as a practice, it would just be the one I'd be working on. I might have two, but I'd just work on the one or, a couple of them on one paper,
mm-hmm.
And let's let that dry just a little bit. Actually, we'll put in one more, and then we'll let that dry, and then I'll show you something. And I can't paint and talk at the same time, so.
Well, we know that.
Oh, my gosh. I got a comment on a video. Beautiful painting, but the show was boring.
Oh.
I thought it was funny.
Our show is never boring.
I can't believe the look on your face.
Oh my gosh.
All right. Are you taking the picture or not? Come on.
I'm trying.
Come on already. You guys, the things I have to deal with. Okay, so here we go. This is hopefully you can see this on screen, but this is basically the same concept, right? So using one singular color. And
wow.
Creating all the depth with that one color.
Let
so,
me see that.
Yes, ma'am. So, I think you're probably right.
I love the monochromatic. I love that.
All right, so I'm going to just make a little bit stronger. A little bit stronger here.
Very pretty. Wow.
And I am going to keep this size brush because for the next step, it will be the right size. And I'm just going to go in here and I'm going to start with, remember we did this one first. It's on top,
yes.
Right? There's nothing going through it. So we're going to start right at the edge and we're just going to go like this with the belly of the brush now. So now we're glazing over the top of what we've already done and we're using the belly of the brush, not the tip, to create like a shadow. Rinse it out. Dab it off, and now we come back, no paint on the brush, and soften that edge. And we're just going to keep on bringing it down until it sort of fades off away. Just rinse the brush and then dab it off on my paper towel.
Andrew's here. Hi, Andrew.
Hi, Andrew. Glad you made it. So again, rinse it off, dab it on my paper towel, and we're just going to pull that down.
Oh, that's cool.
So now we have the shadow. Now, all of a sudden, that thing's ahead of us,
yeah.
Ahead of the rest, right? But I don't really like how harsh these edges are, so I'm just going to go in here with a little bit more water.
Blend them out.
And blend them out. I think I'm just going to do it where the in-betweens are, not where there's a, so this is like, I don't know if this is a bamboo shoot or what this is, but the in-between the shoots is where I'm really doing that. There we go. You see that?
Yeah, cool.
Soft that in just a little bit. Okay. Okay, so that's one side. Now we're going to flip it over and do the other side. So what we're practicing now is how to add a glaze and shadowing.
That's very good.
See how we're doing this? This is fun.
Yeah, and it didn't move the color underneath.
Well, it did a little bit, not
a little bit, but not.
Not like you would expect it to, but see, that's the beauty of Fabriano paper and artist quality paints. And you got to kind of work fast with this because you don't want it to have that harsh edge.
Right.
So. More Lins?
Yeah, but not about you.
Oh, okay. Oh, Sylvia's wrapped up in a blanket or something.
Oh, my gosh. I got to. She's pulsed.
She's so fast.
Oh,
she's on it today. She is on it today.
Oh, my gosh. Okay.
All right. I'm going to make this a little bit stronger here. And you have to kind of sort of be careful because you can't overdo this. So don't push it. If you don't like it, just let it dry and come back later. All right? And remember, this is practice. So now we've just pushed all of that stuff back.
Cool.
That's great.
All right, we just pushed everything else back, and now that one is very, very prominent. Now let's make the next layer. Which one was next? I think it was this one. At least that one looks to be. But I think it needs to dry before we mess with that one. So let's grab another one of our practice sheets. So we've already got that layer, that first layer on there. Like people can walk on it? See, then it's all about what you see, right? It doesn't really matter what I was painting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A skywalk.
Yeah.
A skywalk. I like it. Hopefully it'll be like multiple skylocks.
Oh, Michael Lamb's here. Okay, right. Lins, we need a name. Yes, The Beautiful Yellow is Quinacridone Gold by
This one is M. Gran.
M. Gran.
So we'll put that right there so you can see it there. Okay, I'm going to switch to a smaller brush.
A smaller?
Yeah, I know. Be still her heart. She Holy could cow. Die. All right, so this one is even smaller.
What size is that one?
This one is a 2 from Soho.
Wow, that's really tiny.
Yeah. I think that's the one that I used before. Now, that's what I need for this. Okay, so now, same concept. Same concept. We have a little bit darker than the original... than the original wash, and then we're going to just create some circles. Just take our brush and make some circles, and we're going to have these circles overlapping, and they're going to be different sizes, and we don't care if they're perfect or not. That's not the point of this exercise.
Nice circles.
I'm going to make some big ones here. Once was asked, what's the trick to making a circle? And I think it's about resting your hand, because I don't really know, but I think it's about resting your hand.
Well, I know in the drawing class that you had, you talked about making circles, and it's easier to do like a half of one and then
uh-huh.
connect the
and
other
then meet
half.
Them.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely is. And the more you do it, the more better it is, you know?
Mm-hmm, more better.
For sure. For sure. All right, let's start making some of these overlap. These ones are all in front.
Okay.
We need to make some overlaps.
Fayanne is here. Thank you for joining us. And I think Michael Ann's name is Watch a Windy Watercolor.
Okay.
That's what Lynn
Sounds
is trying
good.
To tell me.
Yeah, definitely drawing two C's that meet each other is definitely the best way to go with putting circles on paper. I like that. That's looking pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Make a big one in behind something.
Oh, yes, ma'am. You heard her. This is not easy to do, but we're gonna. All right, we're gonna go like this. Pick it up off the paper and follow it around just like we were putting it down, right?
Uh-huh.
See how my hand is still in the same position? Even though
I
I'm
like
moving
that you're
the
turning
paper,
the paper.
Even though I'm moving the paper, my hand is still in the same position. Still same angle, so I know that this is where I'm going with it.
Oh, excellent.
It's not perfect, but it's pretty good.
Oh, I like that.
Not bad. All right, how about one more right here? See now what you see what I didn't do? I didn't follow it through. All right, there we go.
There you go.
Okay. We'll let that dry. And we have another one. Now remember, we're just practicing our scales, so we're going to be doing a lot of the same things over and over again, but in different ways. And who knows, we may end up with something that we really like that we could be a concept for could be a concept for a painting later, right?
Yes.
Oh. I wish you guys could see what I see. It's hilarious. Never before has the Kraaft Shaak apron been used in such a super, super way.
I've got my cape on.
All right, so for this one, I'm going to be doing leaves, and I really like when the leaves come down.
Cool.
Wait, I'm not taking
pictures. I'm doing okay. If I always feel like I'm in your way, like somehow I forgot that it's your show, not mine.
He is the photographer.
Speaking of your show, not my show, we are going to be doing a live art concert.
Yes, yay!
In Gilbert, Arizona. So if you are in Arizona and you are watching, you can actually come be a part of this show, just like we're doing today, only there's quite a bit more to it before, during, and after that you might really want to be a part of. The link in the description has all of the details. Go to that link tree link, then you should be able to see the event details and how you can buy tickets.
It's a great event detail that you put out, and you got the theater, and it's going to be spectacular.
I am so excited and scared to death, and yeah, all that. So it should be a blast. Hope everybody will show up and come out. The tickets are available right now, and they will be increasing in price, so you definitely want to make sure you get your tickets right away, and so you don't pay the price that you might not like. And then even better, the first 25 people get a free art print.
Excellent.
Isn't this fun?
Yeah, Fianna is saying that leaves are always harder for me than circles. Somehow my leaves look like they're stuck in between something.
Oh, interesting. In between something. All right, so let's try to figure out, let's figure out what makes this work. So I did a line from the top. Let's do another one. We're going to go, let's go in the middle. Which is not a good idea, by the way, because this right side is still wet.
Uh-oh.
Okay, but we're going to do it anyway. It's okay. Practice. So.
Yeah, it's practice.
All right. And this one is already curving like this. This one is curving this way. So let's curve the opposite way.
Yeah, let's go.
Add
the
a little bit of
way.
Interest to yeah. this thing. All right. Practice doesn't have to be ugly.
Well,
all right?
Nature doesn't grow symmetrically anyway.
No. So I'm just going to go. And I see why. Because I'm right-handed. It's much easier to go across mm-hmm. and bring it down towards me than it is to go this way and go, but that's all right. This is part of the practice. We got to practice even the things that are hard. So we're just going to bring it down.
Practicing the curve scale.
That's right. And we'll come here to an opening. So I have this vine coming down to this opening, and I'm still just using the tip, and I haven't added any more paint. Keep that in mind. And then I do like a backwards C sort of. We're just going to come out. And then come back towards the middle like that. And we're going to do it again on the other side and meet it.
There you go.
And then if you want to make a line down the center, you can.
For the vein. Lynn's saying she doesn't mind small leaves, but most pointed rounds are leafy shaped, when pressed, but I'm with you on bigger ones. They look like a slightly squashed rugby ball or an American football.
Now, what do you say? I mean, the size of these, they're bigger than my thumb. All right, so now we're going to add some. Because this is not, we need it to be bushier, right?
Yes.
So we got to pretend that there's a vine or a part of the stem coming out from behind this leaf, right?
Yes.
And so we just start there and just sort of bring it out. It's much easier to do the leaf when you're not stopping yourself and slowly explaining. It's a lot easier to do it without that.
Hence the quiet.
Hence the quiet, yeah. So we're just going to drag one here. And some of these are not going to be completed because they're behind, right?
Right.
You just got to remember that. And we'll just keep doing it. Some don't necessarily have to go all the way to the end either. Now, I will tell you that they're not all perfect and they're not going to be, but that's, it doesn't matter to me. I kind of like being able to go back and work on a couple too. We're going to show some more stuff here as we're doing this. Oh my gosh. So if you are on Instagram, you got to check out Harry Farmer's daughter as well. If you're not a fan of Lynn's art, you will soon be. And today she is in rare form because she is belting them out faster than I can paint these leaves.
Yeah, she is. It's just amazing. And they're in color too. And they're so detailed.
And I love that she did us a self-portrait this time.
Yes.
Yes.
And then she's got the paintbrush. She's got an arrow saying tiny. Oh my God.
All right, now let's try to do a few more leaves that are solid now. And we're going to use a new technique using the belly of our brush, okay?
Okay, so this is scale number 3?
I'm sure.
Something like that.
I try not to keep track. I just try to do something until I feel like, okay, I've practiced that enough. Much like when I practice the clarinet. I still don't play the clarinet, though. So.
Okay. I was piano, so...
All right, so now I've got a little bit larger brush, gone back to the 8 round brush from Master's Touch, and I'm loading up over here with the paint. So I have a good amount of paint on there, okay? And then I'm going to do this. If you're watching over here on the right side, I'm going to actually pull it out of the paint, and I'm still on there. And I'm going to, as I pull it up, I'm going to make a point.
Okay.
With the brush, okay? Now, these naturally come to their own point, but when you do it like that, you probably notice there was paint left on the thing. So I've just sort of squeezed out the paint. Mm. So it should be just the right amount.
Should be.
All right, so now we're going to just sort of start down here. I'm not sure if I'm on camera. I'm trying to be comfortable and...
You're on
camera at the same time. Okay, so we're going to start with the belly of the brush. We're just going to tap and push it to the left. I'm trying to do this slow.
That's
and then we're going to go
one.
Back to the top, and we're going to push it to the right. And you notice I'm stopping at the one before it. Fill in that little gap there, and there's one leaf. You see that?
Yeah.
Let's do it again. Now I'm going to do a couple more, but I'm probably not going to say anything because it's a little bit easier if I don't. Okay, so I forgot to load my brush properly.
Very sweet. Very sweet looking.
Let's do a couple more. That's pretty good, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Looking real good.
Let's do a few in front. Make sure I got enough paint. Sometimes when you're nervous about what you're going to do, you'd go back and you load a brush you just loaded. That's normal. I do that all the time, just so you know. All right, so I'm going to start right here on top of this one. Hopefully it's dry. And if we're lucky, we can still see the layer underneath. And we can. All right. We're going to do a lot more of those as Sylvia fixes her cape. All right. This one's going to be a little bit odd because it's actually out of frame. So I'm not starting with the tip. I'm starting as if I had already started with the tip.
Yeah.
Now I'm just looking for, where do I want to go next?
Fianna's saying she loves the color combo, and Lisa's saying beautimus. And Junk is saying looks good so far.
There you go. All right, now if you didn't like something, like maybe you made a tip of a leaf not pointy enough, or it wasn't quite what you wanted, this would be where you'd layer over the top of that. So far, I'm pretty happy with these. I think I just need to put one more right up here, and it needs to be pointed a little bit more up. I'm going to have it go behind that one there.
Cool.
Okay. That looks pretty good. We got a few lapping over the top. You can see that. Hopefully it's very, very soft on screen, or at least on this monitor it's very soft. His looks really good. So hopefully on whatever you're watching on, it looks pretty good too.
It's beautiful. I love this color.
Let's go back to our circles. And you know what we haven't done is the Daniel Smith quinacridone gold. Oh. So let's just go ahead and rinse our brush. And why not?
Why not? You haven't used that at all, huh?
No. No, I shouldn't have put out four colors. I should have just stuck with the two, like I said, but I wasn't sure which one to go with. And I'm practicing. Now this one has, you guys can't see
move
that.
Move it over so we can see it. Looks like it's got
this
a little
one,
more orange in it.
Yeah, you're not going to be able to see that either. It's definitely more orangey.
Yeah.
Whereas the other one is more gold-like. And they're not going to see it on screen very well, but. All right, so basically like we did with that first one, what did you call it? The monorail or something? We're just going to go along. Ooh, yeah, that's definitely more orange.
Yeah.
We're going to go along the outside here and sort of outline it, but then sort of push the outline. And we need to clean our brush, dab it off, and then spread out those edges.
Boy, did that circle pop.
And you do have to kind of work this part quickly because these edges will dry,
yeah,
and then you'll be left with that sharp, harsh edge, and you don't necessarily want that. Oh, too much water. I forgot to dab off on the paper towel. Silly me. All right. Let's go back in and keep working. So I've lost my live audience. This is a big reason why we have to do the art concerts, because I need some people who are going to participate with me instead of their phones.
Well, okay, Lynn's is just busy.
Lynn's is posting,
yeah.
So everybody's gone over and talked to her and watch what she's doing. And then T-Dog is like over there checking out Instagram. He forget about posting for Instagram. He's done. Then Sylvia picks up her phone. I've lost the whole audience, you guys. I'm all on my own.
No, we're checking out what other people are posting about.
And then
this.
They use excuses. Listen to this junk.
Everybody's saying we're still here.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I need. I need somebody who's going to actually tell me that the audience is still here. All right, so it's starting to push some forward, push some back, right? I don't know if I like using the second color on this one. I was really happy with the first color. The second color, can you see the splotchiness?
Really? Oh,
yeah.
My goodness.
Look at that close-up. Isn't that weird?
That's because of the...
It's two different paints.
Yeah, yeah. Go back and use M-Gram again.
Well, we've already done it this far, so I'm just going to keep going, but...
I'm bringing my mittens next time.
You should. You should. I mean, it is Arizona. It's 100-something degrees outside. Boy, if Nikki was here, I think she'd be laughing or freezing right along with you, because the two of you are probably very adapted to the heat, whereas I'm like, I can't. I'm dying, personally.
Well, but you're not in the direct, fan path.
No,
that
I wish I was.
Kathleen is saying we're mesmerized, and it's true. I agree. I mean, it's just amazing to watch this.
All right, so now I'm going to... Now, this is another part of the lesson I wanted to go over, is being able to add shadow into something that's round. So now, not only do I want those ones to pop and have some depth behind them, but I also want these ones to have... to be spherical, not just circles. I want them to be more spherical. So how do I do that? Well, we add some depth around the outside.
Liz is saying that she did almost the exact same one with one color. It was a painting negative spaces.
Yeah. And really, the whole purpose for today's scales, keep calling it that, was because I'm ultimately going to be doing the hydrangea painting.
Oh.
And in my mind, like, so when I'm doing a when I'm preparing for a painting, a lot of times I will, I will give myself some time to think about it. You know, it's not just enough to. To practice the brush strokes or to practice the painting or whatever, but I need to think about it too. Like, how am I going to approach this? What do I want to accomplish? And so one of the things that I wanted to accomplish was lots of detail, but lots of negative painting. And I really wanted to be able to use a smaller brush
make
comfortably.
Yeah.
Oh, I just lost my headset.
Uh-oh.
What in the world? That was weird. All I did was move. Sorry if that messed up the sound out there. I apologize, guys. I know, I'm always ruining
Lisa's
the technology.
Oh, Lisa's saying that the circles are turning into moons.
Yeah.
Yes, it looks like it. Yes.
The first thing that I saw with that was planets.
Yeah.
So T-Dog saw it first. Lisa, I'm sorry. You don't win any gold prizes from him. Sorry about that. All right, so I'm just putting much more pigment while it's still wet over here on this side, and then that's allowing that to have that fadeaway distance. But then we also need to make sure we don't forget that this one here is in front, and so there would be a little bit of shadow behind it as well. While it's still wet, I'm just adding in a little bit more pigment. We'll just let that dry.
Wow.
And it looks like Oli from... an old Disney show.
Bye,
but anyway,
junk.
Okay.
Junk has to leave.
All right. So I don't know where we're at on time, but pretty sure we're just about done.
Let me check the digital replacement.
The digital replacement says.
Yeah. We have 2 minutes left.
Well, we did not get to half of what I wanted to do today. So I'm back at this one, and we're going to actually go ahead and do the same thing right alongside.
Back using M-Gram, right?
Oh, heck yeah. Back to M-Gram. Probably going to stay away from the other one for this series because I don't like how the two go together. It doesn't mean
they're
I don't
playing.
Like it.
Yeah.
It does not mean I don't like that color. It just means I don't like how they're playing together.
Right.
So now I'm filling in. I did the shadow, and now I'm filling in with a little bit more of the in-betweens, right?
Right.
And I don't have to explain what the in-betweens are, I hope.
No, we've already been there and done that.
Okay. And this can get confusing, just so you know, what's in between and what isn't. And you want to wait till it's dry. Yep, very much.
Hard to remember.
All right.
Oh, it finally turned off. Oh, my God.
Oh, boy.
It's still glowing.
That's because the ceiling fan's still on. You can turn that off, I told you. Plus, I have a fan directly on me. At least I hope it's on me. It's supposed to be on me. I'm not feeling it, though, but...
Focus issues? There's a problem with focus?
It might be bandwidth or something might have changed.
Okay.
Check your what's that called? Your cogwheel?
Cogwheel, yeah.
Turn the quality down. Or it may have adjusted for you automatically. That may be what happened. I was watching some YouTube channels the other day because, you know, we had that blog hop and everything, and
uh-huh.
I was watching. And I guess my internet didn't much like me watching all those because it did, in fact, drop the quality. Like, you cannot watch a craft video in 122 speed. Or not speed, whatever it is, definition. You can't because it is, you can't see anything.
You can't see anything. Lindsay's saying it's not. You've gone all soft around the edges, and she says, and it's not because I drunk too much gin. You crack me up, lady. And Michael Ann just had to adjust hers. She switched hers back to 720.
Darn that internet. Stopping. Stop. Yeah.
So I'll just go, oh, you're fine.
Yeah.
Can't watch. Just, no.
I don't know if they can hear you at all saying all that, but we have one of our main issues with being on the road and temporarily being at grandma's is internet, and it has been that way since we moved into the motorhome full time. So internet woes are our thing. All right. So you just keep doing that with all the different layers, and as you go back further and further, these areas will get darker and darker and darker until they're just all the way in the back.
Cool.
Pretty cool. And you can keep doing
that.
Great. Now, the one thing that I did want to say, and hopefully this one is dry, so we can do this real quick before we say goodbye. I'm going to grab my teeny tiny brush again.
Ooh.
Yeah, please get another brush. Oh, he needs to take a picture before I ruin it. Those are T-Dog's words.
I said I mean mess with it.
Yeah, uh-huh. Okay, so now, actually, I said I was going to use a smaller brush. I lied to you. Go figure.
Michael Ann wants to know about the board under the painting. Are they expensive, the board that you're using?
Oh, this was a gift from Sylvia, actually. She bought me this last year, remember?
Mm-hmm.
And it was, I don't know, was you think it was like $12?
It wasn't that expensive, yeah.
And this is a perfect size because you
and
can have this
on
your lap.
On
yeah, and if you were watching last week, I used the opposite side and had the clip, and then I realized today, flip it over and use the no clip side. But anyway, I'm going to use the smaller to me, but larger than the other brush. And we're mixing up a much lighter version of this blue. Now, this is where we're going to do some...
Oh, you're using blue?
Yeah, this one is Blue Peacock from Mission Gold. Right here. That's the tube. And just putting in enough water in here so that I get myself a good light wash. All right, and we are going to now add a layer of blue.
Ooh.
But now you'll see that they're going to glaze over the top of that nickel quinacridone gold, and it'll have some green.
Wow.
Okay, so let's watch. Because I can't talk and do it at the same time, obviously. And these are going to be bigger.
Okay, bigger. Bigger with a smaller brush.
Yes.
Okay.
I love these two colors together.
Yeah. Linz was talking about this one, the straight line one, the apps that you were just working on. She says it's looking more like an architect's dream in yellow, all those lines, and that's true. And then Michael Ann saying it reminds her of the LA freeways. Yeah, I agree with that. Oh, look how pretty. Ah, doesn't that look nice?
And now you see they're kind of like the focal point.
Wow.
Can you see
Everything's
that?
Everything's in the background, and look at that.
Let's just do one more down here. This would make a beautiful card. And if I was any good at that hand lettering stuff, I would have this say mom.
Oh.
So just imagine it says mom.
Just
like
imagine.
someone with magical powers, the ability to brush letter, came in and went, mom. Wasn't me. I didn't do it. So
Lisa,
that I like.
Yeah. Lisa's saying, this is so lovely. It is. It really is.
Okay. Now, normally I would tell you, you need to let this air dry. Don't try to force it. Move on to another one. But we're going to force it because we're over time. And I want to add some details to this.
Okay. Don't force it to dry. Let it.
Yeah, that's why I said normally I would say that.
Okay, normally. Okay, but, I missed that normally.
Yeah.
Because I was reading comments. I guess Linz has never seen freeway systems.
Oh.
Don't they have freeways over in England?
I don't think so.
Are you serious?
No, they also don't have the kind of road rage we have either, so don't mess with that.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, that is just heaven on earth then.
Okay.
Ours is horrible.
Okay, so now I'm just going to mix a little bit more intense color. And
so
I have the teeny, teeny, tiny brush.
Brush
now. The teeny, tinier. Yep, they're dry. And we're just going to add these details, okay?
Oh, pretty, pretty. I'm not good with a small brush because you have to use a light hand with that.
You have to use a light hand, and you have to use you have to fill it up more. That's the part that drives me nuts.
Yeah.
I don't like going back to the.
But because
to the
I am
so
heavy-handed, I never get a fine line. I still get a fat line.
Well, I've noticed the different brushes give me a different line. You can use a number two from someone else and not, and it won't have the same effect that this is having. Also, pulling towards you versus pushing away gives a different effect as well. And you'll be able to see. Hopefully you'll be able to see the difference. These were pulled towards me. These were pushed away from me. I don't know if you can see that, but these are a little bit thicker and thinner. Anyway, that's kind of cool. So there we go. These are our musical scales done in watercolor, basically.
Isn't that beautiful?
And this is, you know what we never did? We're going to have to do this. I'll have to do this in a time-lapse video, I think.
Oh, you
this
need
one.
The blue one.
That's a landscape.
Yeah.
And it's still wet, so it needs to be painted, but we got to let it dry. So we'll get back to that one to be continued on a further Kraaft It Live, huh?
Wow.
Maybe next week. Maybe I'll get to that next week instead of the hydrangeas. We'll leave the
Keep
hydrangeas for
them.
June.
Yeah.
I want to do a really good job, so I got to keep practicing.
Well,
all right. What do you think?
It can be June's project.
There you go. Maybe it'll be an all-month-long painting.
Because that picture that you showed is
Yeah, and just
quite
so people
detailed.
People know what we're talking about, this is the hydrangeas I want to paint. And
I
have this.
Look at the detail.
I have this in color, but I did it in black and white so I can see where all the light and darks are. And, yeah, there's a lot of detail.
Yeah.
And I need to be able to, like, sit down and yeah, so we need a different setup than what we got now.
Yeah.
All right, everybody, thank you so much for joining us. I hope you've enjoyed practicing with watercolors, monotone, and then a little two-tone stuff.
Just beautiful.
And we'll have some fun with the blue one. I'll bring that back as well. We'll have some fun with this blue one on another next week. Continue this process.
Look at that. I see a lake. I see misty mountains.
Yep. And my tree disappeared in the water, so I'm going to have to put my tree back in, or it might not be there anymore. Perhaps it just undeveloped.
Yeah, maybe.
What do you see, Travis? Blue.
Mm-hmm. Blue. Part of the tinder fire.
All right, everybody. Thank you for joining us for Kraaft It Live. I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope you learned a little bit of something, but most of all, I hope you get crafty yourself and stick a brush in your hand and get going. If you do play along, if you found this intriguing at all and you decide to do it on your own, please tag us on social media. Let us know. And don't forget that we are going to be live in Gilbert, Arizona, May 29th. Tickets are on sale now. See the link down in the description for more. Thank you, Sylvia, for being here. Thank you, T-Dog, for all of your help. You make all of this so much more enjoyable for everybody. And I appreciate you being here live or recorded. Is there anything else I need to say?
No, it's just I want to thank the audience. They really participated really great today and wants wonderful comments. And they're just loving what you've done today. They just think it's absolutely stunning.
Yay. All right. Have a crafty day, everybody. Bye-bye, Sylvia's hand.
Bye.